In this screencast, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate how I use Microsoft OneNote to record screencast on a tablet PC. I'm capturing the screen with Camtasia, and what I'm showing you is the entire OneNote screen. When I record a screencast, I don't show the entire part of OneNote. I don't show these icons that are up here, for example. I'm doing that here so I can demonstrate how I use OneNote, what some of the advantages are of OneNote. And the other things I want to point out is that I'm using the full page view as opposed to the normal view where I'm going to have displayed the various notebooks and the pages on those notebooks by using the full page view, which I have as an icon also, I get the maximum space for recording. I've set up the recording size so that I have a 16:9 ratio. Likewise, I can go in the view and change the page color. I'm using this light yellow because I think it provides good contrast. I also use these icons to, for example, change the line thickness or the line color so that if I want to emphasize something in a diagram, there's some advantage to using different colors. I can use the pan to bring up something that's further down or to go back and look at something. And one of the advantages of OneNote that I can also pan to the right. And so the pages essentially have semi-infinite width and length. I can just keep adding on. In a screencast, we certainly don't want them very long, so we're not going to go too far down in the page. They also use and find useful is a mini keyboard. So one of the things that's useful when recording is often to pause, enter some information, bring up a figure, bring up some text, and then unpause. And since I'm using a tablet, I don't have access to a normal keyboard. I have a Bluetooth keyboard that's about 5 inches by 2 inches or so that does not take up much desk space and makes it easy to do the pause. So I just paused and wrote this down, and this is often useful when I'm doing calculations. I don't need to show every single number as I write it down. I can explain it later. It becomes more efficient, keeps the screencast at a reasonable length. One of the useful things is sometimes to put in information I'm going to use during the screencast and then pause and bring the information up. So I'm going to show you how I do that while I'm not in the pause mode. What I've done is put in a program. This happens to be a polymath program off the screen, and then I will hit a pause, and the same icon that in search space have just pushed in the other direction with the pen removes space. And now what I've done is bring up this program. I can hit the line icon to remove the spacing, since the typing I think would be much clearer. And then I can discuss this, and one of the advantages of OneNote is I can circle things on this typed material easily. I can also pause, for example. Again, I'm not pausing, just so I can show you how I do this, and bring up a figure or bring up a graph that I've created in a software program after I've had chance to discuss it. And likewise, on these figures, I have the ability to add additional things to the figure, label the figure that this is in D and this is in U. If I make a mistake, I can certainly erase it, or I can hit this undo button. And then when I post-process the screencast, I can take out that mistake. I might use pause to enter equation Might use a different color when I want to discuss one aspect, such as the specific volume of this equation, and I might then use the undo button when I finish discussing that so I don't have my equation too cluttered up for subsequent discussions. The last thing to show you is the actual recording. When I'd be making a screencast, I would not have the icon showing, and so I'll pause and change to show you what that looks like. So this is what my normal recording screen would look like, where you cannot see the icons, but I can write on the page and then go up and change the color and switch to a different color using the icons that are off the page. Makes it very effective for switching back and forth, and I have a large area available for recording. So, just in summary, the use of OneNote is really a very effective way to record screencasts that provide you a lot of options and a lot of versatility.